Welcome to biology class children. Today we are going to discuss chapter 4 activities. Two important activities are there in chapter 4. They are activity 2 and activity 3. Now in this class we are going to discuss these two activities. Look at this activity 2 children. It is very important. Activity 2. What is our aim here? To perform this activity we need to following materials. So here, what is our aim here? Our aim is to prove filtration can be done by using conventional method and also alternative method. Let us see the materials required for this process. Two beakers, funnel. Look at this. This is funnel. Next, this is beaker. Okay. So how many beakers are required? Two beakers and one funnel. Next, filter paper. Next, retard stand. This one is retard stand. Next, sugar. Dye means colored agent. Next, and wheat or rice flour. Next, 500 ml plastic bottle. This is 500 ml plastic bottle. Next, cotton cloth. So these are the materials required for this process. Let us discuss the procedure. Arrange the filtering apparatus as shown in the figure 4a. So like this manner we need to arrange the filtering apparatus. Okay. Next, prepare a wheat or rice powder solution in a beaker by adding 1 teaspoon of powder in 100 ml of water. So first we need to take a beaker. In that beaker we need to add a few grams of wheat powder or rice powder, and we need to add how many ml of water? 100 ml of water in it, and finally we will get a wheat powder solution or rice powder solution. Next, add a drop of tincture iodine solution to it. Next, we need to add one drop of tincture solution to it. Then the solution color will be converted into blue color, like this manner. Here the solution is in blue color. Add a drop of tincture iodine to the solution. Now pour the solution into the funnel. Here now we need to pour the solution into the funnel. So before pouring the solution into the funnel, we need to insert filter paper in the funnel, and we need to arrange one large glass beaker at the bottom of this funnel. Then what will happen when we pour the wheat solution or rice flour solution? Then what will happen? Simply move through the filter paper, and filter paper useful for filtering. Then what will happen? Clear solution will reaches to the beaker, glass beaker, and rice flour or wheat flour can be left over the surface of this filter paper. Finally, if you observe the glass beaker, then there is a chance to see the glass beaker consisting solution. Which solution? Rice flour solution or wheat flour solution in it. If you observe the filter paper contains some larger particles presented in the wheat flour or rice flour. What it indicates? It indicates that the filter paper is useful for filtering purpose. So, like this manner, cells are also useful in our body to allowing the substances to pass through the plasma membrane. Like filter paper, here also we have one membrane in our cells. This membrane is called plasma membrane. This membrane is also useful for the transportation of substances like filter paper. Let us see. Second method. This method is also called alternative procedure or alternative method. It is also useful for filtration process. First, we need to take an empty water bottle. Cut the mouth part of empty water bottle. Then we will get two parts. One is bottom one part, it acts as like this beaker. Next one is mouth part, this is acts as like this funnel. Okay, now invert that particular mouth part of the water bottle or the surface of beaker part. Okay, now cover it with a filter paper and pour the rice flour solution or wheat flour solution that we have prepared in figure A. Okay, if you pour the solution through this mouth part of the bottle, then what will happen? It contains a filter paper in it. This filter paper allows the materials which are having very very smaller particles in it, the remaining particles will be left over the surface of this filter paper. So finally, basing on this alternative procedure also, we can find that the filtration is done accurately with the help of filter paper. Like this manner, our cells are also contains plasma membrane. This plasma membrane is also useful for filtering purpose, which is useful to send the useful materials only into the cells. Okay children, now we are going to discuss next important activity, that is activity 3. Here materials required for this process: 3 beakers. See, this is beaker 1, beaker 2, next beaker 3. How many beakers are required? 1, 2, 3. 3 beakers are required. Next petri dish. Next salt, dilute HCl means dilute hydrochloric acid solution, or toilet cleaning acid we need to use. Next 2 equal sized rayaks means pachi eggs, 2 eggs, cloth to wipe. Next a strip of paper for measurement and 1 tablespoon. Next 1 tablespoon. So these are the materials required for this process. Let us see the procedure. Keep the rayax in dilute HCl solution or toilet cleaning acid for 4 to 5 hours. Let us see. In this beaker there is a chance to see toilet cleaning acid or dilute HCl solution. If you keep the rayax in dilute HCl solution or toilet cleaning acid, then what will happen? Here there is a chance to see some bubbles will come. What it indicates? It indicates the dissolving of calcium carbonate shell present on the surface of egg. After 4 to 5 hours, what we can observe? The total shell presented around the egg will disappear. Now we need to take out the egg with the help of a tablespoon, and we need to wash the egg under the tap water. That particular egg is called D-shelled egg. And finally we will obtain that D-shelled egg like this manner. Okay, next what we are going to do? Now we need to measure the circumference of each egg with the help of a long strip of paper. We need to measure the circumference of each egg. Next, at which place? At its widest place. Where is the widest place? This is the widest place. Here this is the widest place. So at this place only we need to identify the circumference of each and every egg. Now prepare concentrated salt solution in a beaker. Now we need to take another beaker. In that beaker we need to fill it with a concentrated salt solution. Means we need to take more amount of salt and less amount of water in it. Next, place one egg in the beaker with tap water. Next, and place the other in the salt water. Look at the first one, figure 5c, D-shelled egg in salt solution. So here this one is salt solution. Next, in second beaker there is a chance to see tap water. So now we need to keep 2 D-shelled eggs in 2 beakers. In beaker 1, salt solution is there. In beaker 2, tap water is there. Now take the eggs out, wipe them and measure the circumference of each and every egg with a strip of paper and mark on the paper with a pen or pencil. This procedure we need to do after 2 to 4 hours. After 2 to 4 hours, if you remove these two eggs, if you observe the circumference again in the same eggs, then there is a chance to see difference in the circumferences. Here in figure 5c, we kept a dish egg in salt solution. So because of the entering of salt solution into the dish egg, what will happen? Dish egg loses its extra water. So its circumference will be decreases after 2 to 4 hours. But here we kept in the tap water. Tap water always enters into the dish egg. As a result of this, what will happen? Dish egg circumference will be gradually increases. What it indicates? It indicates that the plasma membrane shows permeability. Permeability means it allows some materials through it and it removes some materials through it. Means it shows osmosis process.